amazing channel. Today we are going to change the belt tensioner on the SS. It threw the belt twice now, and the only thing that it could be by diagnosing all the other pulleys are fine. So it is too nice to park it yet. I would like to go drive it today. It means we have to get this going. In order to change the tensioner on the SS, you need a 15 and a 13 millimeter, pretty much what you need for everything on this car. So, first we have to take the supercharger pulley and bracket off because that is in the way of the belt tensioner. So let's get it started. There is two pulleys on the bracket assembly for the supercharger drive that have to come off before the bracket. And the only reason I gotta take that off is to get the new belt back on. The tensioner hits it while you're trying to put the belt back on. So, move parts of the shredded old belt. Yeah, that's not too pretty. There is four 13 millimeter bolts that hold the bracket on. Those come off fairly simple. You will want a shallow socket because it will hit your fan assembly when you're trying to take them out. There we go. with the new, it is always good to compare and make sure that they look the same, that everything's correct. Buying stuff from part stores, sometimes you get the wrong stuff. I work at a part store and know that. So, things happen. We're all human. We make mistakes. These are 15 millimeter bolts. You will need a deep socket for that, or at least an extension to reach past the pulley. And just like that, the new belt is on. Pulleys check, make sure that all the pulleys are right after it's on. And we can start putting the supercharger belt back on. there you have it. Very simple to do. That'll obviously be a lot faster to change it without the supercharger in the way, but pretty simple job. 5-10 minutes. If I had power tools going, it'd be a lot quicker, but. We'll start it and make sure everything's good.